This just isn't worth it.
In 2017, you said that pipelines through treaty lands were a non-starter. What's that? What do you mean by that?
So can we talk, Ab? And the way we do.
I would be
glad. Can I finish and then we can talk?
What changed? You said it was a non-starter.
Can I finish and then we can talk?
This is the most pressing issue in our state.
Okay. I'll be glad to talk to you when we finish, though.
These protesters crashed a Democratic Party event demanding that Tim Walz, the governor of Minnesota, a Democrat, actually do something to address the pipeline, noting that he had previously said that a pipeline cutting through indigenous land was a non-starter, and yet now giving approval to the Line 3 pipeline. Tim Walz has done very little to stop the pipeline from happening, and any attempt to stop or limit the brutality against indigenous protesters is effectively not materialized. As you may remember, a few weeks ago, police used a helicopter to terrorize Line 3 protesters. These are water protectors who are trying to stop a pipeline from cutting through indigenous land. They're also trying to stop the pipeline so that future oil spills don't poison the Mississippi River, which is a source of drinking water for many people in Minnesota. The situation has escalated to the point where water protectors have been arrested in northern Minnesota, in addition to water protectors who sat on the Capitol lawn being arrested while they were holding a rally. Now let's be clear, the ones who were on the Capitol lawn had organized this protest and they were on public land where people regularly hold protests. In fact, the day after, there was an anti-mask protest and those anti-maskers were not arrested. No, but for some reason, whenever indigenous people show up to organize to demand Democrats to recognize their tribal sovereignty, the Democrats show up to tell them to sit down. And they respond to them with militarized violence and arrests.
What I would say too is that our party follows.
Now is the time. Protect the sacred, stop the pipeline.
Okay.
You can see here in the video that Tim Walz was about to say that the Democrats follow the science, despite the fact that literally New York just flooded from a hurricane that hit Louisiana. The hurricane cut its way all the way up to the northeastern states from Louisiana. This is a climate crisis we are in the middle of right now, and Tim Walz has the audacity to claim that he is following the science by allowing an oil pipeline to pollute our environment and reinvest in fossil fuels while also violating tribal sovereignty in that very act. As you may recall, a couple of years ago, Joe Biden was similarly challenged on his record on deportations, and Joe Biden's response was, "Go vote for the Republicans."
There were 3 million people that were deported and separated from their families.
Yeah.
We had this classification of families.
You should vote for Trump.
Families.
You should vote for Trump.
And I'm not gonna do that.
And this shows the shamelessness of the Democrats. We are rapidly accelerating towards an absolute crisis. They are literally plowing their way through indigenous lands. They are literally polluting indigenous lands. They are violating treaties. And then they are turning around and saying, well, who else are you going to vote for? We cannot allow the left to be held hostage by this Democratic Party that is so willing to literally throw people under helicopters, buses, and bulldozers. We cannot allow this Democratic Party to destroy the environment because they think that it's strategic to take money from fossil fuel companies. And the problem isn't just people like Kyrsten Sinema and Joe Manchin. The problem is also people like Tim Walz and Joe Biden. This is Ben Carolla with Rebel Headquarters. You can catch my show Galaxy Brain on the Young Turks Twitch channel every Friday at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. You can also follow me on Twitter if you want to stay up to date with my content.